Hi viewers, welcome to Win and Shine. In the era of 20th century, there was a huge protest that we need independence. Who are you to rule me? Quit from India. Reflection of these voices, British announced India will be independent on August 15, 1947 and we will leave from India. On August 15, 1947, India officially got independence. But a question arised, was India fulfilled? Once we got independence, truly to say, the answer was no. Our leaders thought that here we need our own rules, own regulations. People of India have to claim their own rights by some regulations. So they formed a constituent assembly for this. Mr. Sachinananda Sinha was appointed as temporary president on December 9, 1946. On December 11, 1946, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, who was the first president of our Freedom India, became the permanent president of the Constituent Assembly. This assembly constituted of many committees like finance, power and so on. The drafting committee, which was headed by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, featured as an important committee. Along with seven members, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar framed the constitution and finalized it on November 26, 1949. This was fully a handwritten and the lengthiest constitution of the world. Here, they wrote 22 parts, 8 schedules and 395 articles. At present, there are 25 parts, 12 schedules and 448 articles. But we are celebrating November 26 as Constitutional Day only and not as Republic Day. Do you know why? For this, we have to look back our history on January 26, 1930 of Indian National Congress Lahore session. On that day, Jawaharlal Nehru announced Purna Swaraj, which means India got full independence, but British refused it. But to remind this day, our leaders selected January 26 as Republic Day. Okay, fine. Then what is the difference between Independence Day and Republic Day? On both days, we hoist flag and declare holiday. But what is the difference? Here is the explanation. On Independence Day, we will look back the history, speak and realize about our freedom fighters and the moments of independence. But on Republic Day, we analyze the stand of India. India is one of the leading democratic countries in the world. On this day, India will showcase her current power and development by Army, Navy and Air Force. All the three will march uniformly and various cultural events will be conducted. On Independence Day, people elected leader Prime Minister will hoist flag in New Delhi and in state, Chief Minister will hoist the flag. On Republic Day, the protector of our constitution, President, will hoist flag in New Delhi and in state, Governor will do it. Apart from this, there is more important reasons why to celebrate Republic Day. January 26 makes way for every citizen to breathe the freedom air. January 26 makes way for every citizen to elect their representative as they like. January 26 allows citizens to convey their likes and dislikes by a single vote. India is not a word. India, it is an emotion. It is a bridge between every citizen to live in unity. Proud as an Indian, happy Republic Day. Jai Hind.